So much buzz about American Hustle, the highly anticipated film from David O. Russell, with an Oscar-nominated and winning ensemble cast, including Amy Adams. She's pulling double duty, juggling two men, two accents. One of them is British. You look great, hon. We're going to take a look, and then we'll chat.
Thank you.
Okay.
And you wonder, like, am I ever going to get out to a better place, or is this it? You feel like that?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. I definitely know that. I'm sorry, we don't have to go dancing. We can go have coffee or talk or something.
No, no. No, no, I need this. Please, I need to go dancing with you. Please.
Okay, baby, let's go dancing.
And yes, they went dancing. You went to a discotheque.
Yeah.
Amy's good to have you back in.
Thank you. Good to be here.
You're a real woman. You came in just now, putting on your shoes. Family all around.
You know, you gotta juggle it. You know, you can't. These shoes aren't built for speed. So you know.
It's great, yeah. And that's what we really, really appreciate you for.
Thank you
for so many different reasons.
Thank you. This particular
character, a little complicated. She is.
Yeah, she's very complicated. She's got a lot going on. You know, juggling two men and. Her own misery and all of that, yes.
Yeah, I know she wasn't happy with who she is, and so she has this different person that she has become, and she fools a lot of people, including the FBI agent, played by Bradley Cooper.
Exactly. We get ourselves in some trouble, and I've sort of adapted this. It's funny, I was watching the Downton Abbey cast and Lady Edith, and I'm like, I'm playing Lady Edith.
Yes, so you are.
There you go. So she adopts this sort of persona and fools him and tries to manipulate him, and it's good fun.
Yeah, well, you said that you really enjoyed some of the scenes that you did, like one with Christian Bale, who, again, every time he takes on a role, he becomes that person. And there's this wonderful scene. You guys are barely saying anything in the dry cleaners.
Yeah.
That really spoke to you, too.
It did. It was one of my favorite scenes. I always love the quiet scenes in movies. And he does this thing when his glasses come off. He just looks at her so intimately and so vulnerably. And it's one of those things, like, if a man looks at you like that, they're just giving you their soul. And it's such a precious gift.
And on the flip side of that, because that was, as you said, it was just very soulful and very peaceful. Then you hauled off and you hit Bradley Cooper's character.
Oh, yeah.
And then you had to really be talked into it?
Well, you know, I believe you can accomplish something without hurting someone. So I kept hitting him, and I guess it wasn't reading his heart enough. So David's yelling, hit him, hit him. Bradley's yelling, hit me. So I did, and his face started swelling.
In real life it started swelling.
Oh, yeah, it started swelling. I was like, I certainly hope you have it, because I think Bradley needs some ice. I felt very badly about that.
But it seemed like you all just really got along. And Jennifer Lawrence, boy, she jumps off the screen.
She does. She's just unstoppable. She's a phenomenon. And she, in this character, just has so much to work with and really embraces this sort of insanity that's created. And we have this scene here that...
This was your idea.
So it's at the end of it.
We don't want to give it away.
Yeah,
oh, let's not give it away. But
well, the end of it was. Well, I was just thinking, like, my character is so strong and so angry. Why would I let her walk out of the room? Like, what could she do that would get me to just freeze? And I said, well, what if she does this? And she was game. And that's the wonderful thing about Jennifer. She's just up for anything, and she's just fantastic.
Well, everybody is holding her own on that.
Yeah.
And then the different. You must have changed costumes like 50 times.
About 50 times, yeah.
Oh, and we saw a little bit of that in the Vanity Fair. Beautiful pictures in that
as
well.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Was that part of it?
Well, yeah. I mean, she's trying on all of these different personas and all of this sort of. So the costumes were a big part of how she defines herself and how it's like her armor, really, you know. But it seems to be that the stronger she feels, the less clothes she wears, or the stronger she wants to feel. She uses it as a manipulation and as a weapon. But it was such an insane shoot that a lot of the costume changes were like in a closet at some warehouse. You know, you're just finding anywhere you can change and maintain some amount of dignity and modesty, which is...
It worked.
Thank you.
We felt like we were in the 70s. The hair, everyone had like a different style going, and it was just...
We had a great design team. Really, really lucky with everybody we worked with. Michael Wilkinson, who did the costumes, and Kathy and Evelyn, who did the hair and makeup. Just really... really ambitious and went for it.
Yeah, well, Josh gives it 2 thumbs up, and I saw it last night. I do too. It is great. And just, again, the cast all coming together, the director, everything. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Enjoy your family.
I will.
You know, have a good time through the holiday season. And American Hustle opens in select theaters this Friday, nationwide next Friday, December 20th.